Francis turbine tutorial question number 3. Hydraulic efficiency of a Francis turbine can be written as this equation, where the total loss here is in the turbine and HB here is the net head. If total loss is minimum, the hydraulic efficiency will become maximum. Define an expression for whirl velocity at outlet with maximum hydraulic efficiency. The total losses can be expressed here as this equation. For reaction turbine, head loss of relative velocity is 5% and head loss at draft tube is 20%. Velocity of flow is constant at 7.5 meter per second. U2 equals 15 meter per second. At maximum efficiency, the net head is 90 meter. Determine the whirl velocity at outlet, the guide vane angle at outlet, the blade angle at outlet, and the hydraulic efficiency. From the question, the hydraulic efficiency can be determined as hydraulic efficiency eta equal to minus 1 minus total losses divided by HB. When total losses is minimum, the hydraulic efficiency will become maximum. And the total losses can be written as sigma HL equal K1 VR2 square over UG over 2G plus K2 V2 square over 2G. And the question 1 to define an expression for V2, which is the whirl velocity at outlet with maximum hydraulic efficiency. First, you need to draw your velocity triangle like this. And from this question, we know that the whirl velocity at outlet is not equal to zero. So, the velocity triangle at outlet here need to be drawn like this. We have absolute velocity 2 here. And then we have component VR2 and U2 here. And also, we have component of VF2 like this and VWL2 like this. From this velocity triangle, we know that V2 square here is equal to VWL2 square plus VF2 square. It can be written like this. And then, we could write also the value or the term about VR2 here is equal to U2 minus VWL2 square to get the value at this area plus VF2 here, VF2 square, to fulfill the trigonometry like this. And then at maximum efficiency, the total losses is equal to zero. So from this statement, we can write a mathematical expression like this. Sigma HL equal to zero equal to K1 VR2 square over 2G plus K2 V2 square over 2G. This equation is given in a question. Then, because in this equation, we have term of VR2 and V2 here, we substitute these two terms with this parameter that we already calculated previously. We substitute the value and we get this term. To simplify this term, we differentiate the term as d sigma HL over d whirl 2. It is equal to 0 and the term will simplify like this. So we expand and we solve this equation, we could get V whirl 2 is equal to K1 over K1 plus K2 times U2. So it is mean that when whirl velocity at outlet is equal to K1 over K1 plus 2 times U2, the hydraulic efficiency will become maximum. So this is the term of V whirl 2 or velocity of whirl at outlet when hydraulic efficiency is maximum. From question, we know that the relative velocity loss is 0.05. So we could write as 0.05 VR2 VR square over 2G. And the losses at the draft tube is 20%. So we could write as 0.2 V2 square over 2G. Why we use V2 here? Because V2 here is the actual velocity that comes out from the Francis turbine. And also from the question, we know that the total losses, sigma HL, is equal to K1 VR2 square over 2G plus K2 V2 square over 2G. If we compare with this equation, we could say that we could assume that K1 here is equal to 0.05 and K2 here is equal to 0.2. And then from the question, it is say that VF1 is equal VF2, and we could write only VF only here, and it is equal to 7.5 meter per second. So it says that the flow velocity is constant and U2 is equal to 15 meter per second. Now we are calculating the whirl velocity at outlet. At maximum efficiency, we could say that from our previous calculation, V whirl 2 is equal K1 over K1 plus K2 times U2. We substitute the value of K1 and K2 here, and the value of U2 here, we could get the whirl velocity at outlet is equal to 3 meter per second. Then we need to calculate the guide vane angle at outlet. So this is the outlet velocity triangle, and the guide vane angle can be assumed it is equal to alpha 2, which is equal to here or here. So if the angle is here, we could determine the angle here, let's say alpha 2 here, is equal to VF2 over V2. Then we substitute the value of VF2 and V2. We could calculate the value of alpha 2 here is 68.2 degree. Next, we need to calculate the blade angle at outlet. So this is outlet and blade angle is beta 2. From the trigonometry, we could say tangent beta 2 is equal to VF2 U2 over U2 minus V2. We substitute all the parameter here. We could calculate beta 2 is equal to 32 degrees. Next, we need to calculate the hydraulic efficiency. From the question, we know that the hydraulic efficiency can be calculated by using this equation. Hydraulic efficiency equal 1 minus total losses divided by HB. From the question also, the value of HB is given as 90 meters. And the equation to calculate the total losses, sigma HL here is K1 VR2 square over 2G plus K2 V2 square over 2G. From previous calculation, we could get K1 is equal to 0.05. VR2 square can be calculated by using this equation. We get 200.25 meter per square, meter per second square. K2 is equal to 0.2 and V2 square can be calculated by using this equation and it is equal to 65.25 meter square over second square. We substitute all this value into this equation, we could get the total losses is equal to 1.175 meters. Then we could calculate the hydraulic efficiency by this equation. We substitute the value and we get it is 0.987 or it is equal to 98.7%.